Our topic for today are the drugs for Parkinson's disease. Parkinson's disease is a slowly progressive neurodegenerative disorder that afflicts more than 1 million in Northern America and is second only to Alzheimer's disease as the most common degenerative disease of neurons. The cardinal symptoms are tremor, rigidity, postural instability, and slow movement. In addition to these motor symptoms, most patients also experience non-motor symptoms, especially autonomic disturbances, sleep disturbances, depression, psychosis, and dementia. And now, for the model of neurotransmitter in the healthy striatum and Parkinsonian striatum. So in the healthy striatum, dopamine release from neurons originating in the substantia nigra inhibits the firing of neurons in the striatum that release your gamma-aminobutyric acid, or your GABA. Conversely, neurons located within the striatum, which releases the acetylcholine, excite the GABAergic neurons. Therefore, under normal conditions, the inhibitory actions of your dopamine are balanced with the excitatory action of your acetylcholine, leading to your controlled movement by the globus pallidus. On the other hand, in Parkinson's disease, the neurons that supply your dopamine to the striatum degenerate. In the absence of sufficient dopamine, the excitatory effects of your acetylcholine is unopposed and disturbed movement results. So the drugs that are employed in Parkinson's disease are in two types. First are your dopaminergic agents. So these are agents that directly or indirectly activate your dopamine receptors. Second will be your anticholinergic agents. That is, they are the drugs that block the receptors for acetylcholine. Of the two groups, dopaminergic agents are far more the more widely employed in Parkinson's disease. So here are the drugs used in Parkinson's disease. First are your dopamine replacement. So we have here the levodopa and the carbidopa. So levodopa undergoes conversion to dopamine in the brain and activates the dopamine receptors, while your carbidopa blocks the destruction of levodopa in the periphery. So they are the first line drug for Parkinson's disease. Then we have here the dopamine agonists. So they are divided into non-ergot and ergot derivatives. So they directly activate your dopamine receptors. So pramipexole and rupinerol are first line drugs or supplements to levodopa, while your amoxicillin, a sub-Q non-ergot agent, is reserved for rescue therapy during off times. Then we have your COMT inhibitors. COMT stands for catechol-O-methyltransferase inhibitors. So they inhibit breakdown of levodopa by your COMT. So they are adjunct to levodopa. Next will be your MAO-B inhibitors. MAO stands for monoamine oxidase B. So they inhibit breakdown of dopamine by your MAO-B. So they are used in newly diagnosed patients and for managing off times during your levodopa therapy. And we have here your dopamine releaser. So amantadine promotes release of dopamine from remaining dopamine neurons and may also block your dopamine reuptake. So they may help reduce your levodopa-induced dyskinesias. So here are the preparation for your levodopa combinations. So we have levodopa and carbidopa. The trade name is Cenemet. So the dosage is highly individualized. So since food reduces absorption, we should give this drug on empty stomach. We also have a combination of levodopa and carbidopa and entacapone with a trade name Stalevo. They may be given with or without food. However, foods that are high in fat may delay the absorption. So tablets should be swallowed whole. Now for your dopamine agonist and ergot derivatives, your bromocriptine and your carbigoline. So they can be administered with food or meals to decrease the GI symptoms. We also have the dopamine agonists or the non-ergot derivatives, which are the pramipexole and your ropinirole. So they may be taken with or without food and they should be swallowed whole. Same with your pramipexole, ropinirole should be given either with or without food and should be swallowed whole. Here we have bruticotine. So the preparation is a 24-hour transdermal patch. So in early stage Parkinson's disease, the starting dose is 2 mg patch every 24 hours. While on advanced stage of Parkinson's, they can be given with 4 mg patch every 24 hours. So administration, we apply it to skin that is clean, dry, hairless, and free of abrasions or cuts. Then we also have the apomorphine. So they are given in a multi-dose injector pen. So the package labeling states that all patients should take an antiemetic starting 3 days before the first dose. Then we also have the COMT inhibitors in entacapone. They are in 200 milligram tablets. It can be given with or without food. Another COMT inhibitor is your tolcapone in 100 milligram tablet, and they can be also be given with or without food. Now for the MAO-B inhibitors, we have selegiline. It can be given in capsule, tablet, or your ODT or oral disintegrating tablet. So ODT should be placed on top of tongue and allowed to dissolve. So we take ODT before breakfast and allow at least 5 minutes before drinking or eating after administration. We also have prasugrel. So they can be given as monotherapy or adjunctive therapy with levodopa. They may be taken with or without food. And we also have the antiviral agent amantadine that can be given in tablet, capsule, and syrup. They may be taken with or without food. However, the food decreases GI upset. And anticholinergic drugs are also used in Parkinson's disease because they relieve symptoms by blocking the cholinergic receptors in the striatum. So we have here the benztropine. So benztropine is given either in tablet or solution for injection. So they may be taken with or without food. IM injection is preferable because for Parkinson's disease, IV injection doesn't provide an advantage. We also have the trihexyphenidyl. So they can be given in tablet or elixir. And they may be taken with or without food. And thank you for watching.